Ethan Carter, I didn't know. But he knew who I was. When the police won't help you and the priests don't believe you, you call on Paul Prospero. You call on me. If you're a kid like Ethan, you're right. Plenty do. Ethan's letter started out just like any other fan mail. But soon there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to hide from me. Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. No trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow.
Thank you. Thank you. What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing. I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
You can feel it, right? Something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it. Ethan disturbed the steamer.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Really? Okay, I will.
Have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy. You've all gone crazy.
Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
It's not my fault. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Thank you.
I've stepped through too many portals, been present in too many worlds simultaneously. Bits and pieces of me stay on the other side, waiting. Whenever I return, I bring parts of those worlds back. Do you know what ghosts are? They're sad, evicted things. Memories without homes. What do the dead have to say? You'd be surprised by how little they know. The dead can't explain what it means to be dead. They walk down stairs that disappear beneath their feet, headed for some bright blade of memory they'll never reach.
come here for many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future. And I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me. If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you. Does sin come from the heart or the mind? Do you feel there is vanity, charity? Would you prefer anonymity over notoriety? When you close your eyes, whose voice do you hear? Do you admire thieves for their bravery or their greed? Do you take that which you know you will not return? Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat.
Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real.
That's what people respond to.
Reality.
Thank you. Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
No, huh? What the hell's wrong with you exactly?
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. They're freaking everyone out.